The SMS Desktop Software provides several options for printing reports of the data contained in the management tree. These reports have similar formatting to the General Summary screen in the main mapping window. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create, edit, and print reports and summary data. To print the General Summary screen, select the data in the management tree you wish to use. The summary window will update and display the default information for the selected operation, in this case, a fertilizing dry operation. To modify what data is included in the summary, right-click anywhere on the summary and click Edit General Summary Design. In the Select the Items to be Displayed dialog, use the Available Items selection to select what additional items you would like to add to the summary. Let's say we wanted to see the total amount of each mix component applied. Since the rate is an attribute, select Attribute Statistics and search for Rate or use the drop-downs to select the desired item. Then, select the data source. Since it was log data, select Spatial Data Records. Then, the desired statistic, which is total. You can also change the name of the item seen in the report in the title text box. With your item selected, click Add in the middle to add the items to the right under Selected Items. The selected items are the items that are displayed in the summary if available. For certain items, you have additional settings, including Add Mix Component Attributes and Use Default Units. Check Mix Component Attributes to break out the amount of each product defined in a product mix. Use Default Units if you want to use the default units for the selected item. Otherwise, uncheck the box to select alternative units instead of using the default units. When finished, click OK. Once the summary contains the information you desire, you can print the summary by clicking on the print icon in the main toolbar, selecting print from the file menu, or right-clicking over the summary window and selecting print. There's also an option to save data as an HTML document when right-clicking on the report. The HTML file can then be dropped into a spreadsheet for use outside of the software. If you would like to create reports within multiple layers of information, we can create a general report. To create a general report, select Reports in the main toolbar, then select General Reports in the Report selection options. For more information on other report options, check out the cards above. Click Create a General Report at the bottom. In the Report Type selection, you will see a listing of all existing reports and a description of each report. These include Grower Summary, Condensed Farm Report, Crop Type, Product Operation Resource Usage, and more. These default reports will group separate reports according to their description. Select the type of report you would like to generate, and then click Next. The Select Data Filters dialog will open where you can select what data you wish to have included. If you wish to include weather data, check Include Weather and enter the time span you'd like to gather data from. Click Next. After setting the filters, the Edit Data Filter results window will open and you can use the Delete button to remove any unwanted datasets from the output of your report. Click Next. Use the Report Items selection screen to modify what attributes and properties will be included in the completed report. If you need to modify the selected items, click Edit below the selected items and use the selection tools to add and remove the desired items. Then click OK. To change weather data, select Change and modify weather attribute settings as necessary. Display settings allows users to change the grouping, placement, and comparison average settings. Use the drop-down under Grouping By to group data by month or growing season. Use the drop-down under Placement to place data after each block or at the end of the report. Check Include Comparison to compare averages for the previous year, the last 5 years, or the last 10 years. Click Next to go to the report options. Here, you can make any changes to the report's title, the summary data type referenced, report colors, and the option to select your logo. Page break settings control how the report will print. Start each report on a new page will be selected by default, having each report print on its own page. For example, if we had the selected crop summary report, and the data we selected has corn, soybeans, and wheat, each crop type will be on a separate page, not combined with another report. No page breaks will print report pages continually across the pages with no regard for where a report will be divided. This will use the least amount of paper. The last option is minimal page breaks, which will try to intelligently place reports so you can get as many separate reports on an individual page without having partial reports on separate pages. Once you have your settings the way you would like for this report, and you would like to apply your changes to future reports, click Save as Default. To restore the report to factory settings, click Restore Original. With your changes complete, click Finish. The final report will now be displayed. You can modify the report further by right-clicking on the report and selecting Edit Report Options. If you want to modify the data in the report, select Edit Report Filter to open the Data Filters window. To print this report, either go to File, Print, or right-click on the report and select Print. Once again, you can save the report as an HTML file by right-clicking and selecting Save as HTML. Now you will be able to create, edit, and print general and summary reports in the SMS Desktop software. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.